Good morning, students. Welcome to your computer class. In our last class, I told that in next class we will start Java. But unfortunately, we cannot start Java today because in chapter 2, one thing is left, that is Boolean algebra. So in today's class, we will learn the algebraic method to simplify a Boolean expression and to prove a Boolean equation. So let's start with simplification of Boolean expression using Boolean laws. So for that, we have to remember the equivalence laws, those we have already learned. So let's start with simplification of a Boolean expression. Xy whole naught plus x naught plus xy. This is one Boolean expression. We have to simplify this expression. How? Now let me rearrange this product terms. Xy plus xy whole naught plus x naught. Now xy plus xy naught equal to 1 according to the complementarity law. Then plus x1 remains as it was. Now 1 plus x0 equal to 1 according to the property of law. So this is the simplified value of this Boolean expression. This is very simple. Now sometimes in question, it will be mentioned to specify the Boolean laws in each steps for the simplification. So in that case, for this xy plus xy whole naught equal to 1, we have to write here xy plus xy whole naught equal to 1. And law also we have to write in bracket, that is complementarity law. Complementarity law. And next one is properties of 1. X naught plus 1 equal to 1, that is properties of 1. Now next, another one. X naught, Y naught, z naught plus x naught y z naught plus xy plus xy naught z naught. Now from these two product term we have to take x naught z naught common, x naught z naught, and here we are getting y naught plus y. And then from here, xy plus xy naught z naught, we are getting xy plus z naught. This is the third distributive law. So here you can write xy plus xy whole naught z naught equal to xy plus z naught according to the distributive law. Now from here, y plus y naught or y naught plus y equal to 1, that is according to the complementary law. So here x naught z naught into 1 plus xy plus z naught y plus y naught equal to 1. Complementarity law. Then we are getting what? X naught z naught plus xy plus z naught. Now if I take z naught from these two term common, then z naught into x naught plus 1 and here this xy. So again x naught plus 1 for 1. So z naught into 1 plus xy. So here also we have to write the law x0 plus 1 equal to 1, that is properties of 1. Properties of 1 law. Now ultimately we are getting what? Z0 plus xy, or we can write xy plus z naught. So this is the simplified expression of this Boolean expression. Clear? Now let's take another example. AB plus AC whole naught plus AB naught C into AB plus C. So here AB plus AC naught, then you multiply AB naught C into AB plus A B naught C into C. So what we are getting here, the next step, AB plus AC whole naught plus B into B naught for 0. So 0 into anything for 0. And here A B naught C into C. C into C for C. So A B naught C. This is according to the idempotence law. Then AB plus AC whole naught plus A B naught C. Now from these two we are getting what? AC naught plus B naught according to the distributive law. AC naught plus B naught. How we are getting? This is AC naught and A B naught C means AC B naught. So if this is X, then this is X naught and this is what? Y. So if this is X, this is X naught and this is Y. So X plus X naught Y equal to X plus Y. So at the place of X, actual value is AC naught and Y's value is B naught. So AC naught plus B naught. So AC naught plus B naught. Now from this two, again according to the distributive law, B naught plus BA means A plus B naught and here AC whole naught. Now we will put this in De Morgan's law to find out the equivalent of AC naught. A B naught plus A C whole naught equal to A naught plus C naught. Now A plus A naught for 1, that 1 plus B naught plus C naught. So 1 plus B naught equal to 1 according to the property of 1 and that 1 plus C naught equal to again 1. So ultimately final value is 1, which is the simplified value of this expression. Understood? Now we will prove one Boolean equation. Let's take one distributive law. X plus YZ equal to X plus Y into X plus Z. Take the right hand side expression and simplify this to check that simplified value is equal to X plus YZ or not. So you multiply X into X for X plus X into Y for XY plus X into Z for XZ plus Y into Z for YZ. Now if I take X common, so here 1 plus Y for 1. So X into 1 for X. So I am showing 1 plus Y and here XZ YZ. Then from here X into 1 means X plus XZ plus YZ. Now X plus XZ means again X, because if I take X common, here it will be 1 and here plus Z. So 1 plus Z for 1, that 1 into X for X. Then X plus YZ. See here, we got the left hand side value. Here we can write tens root. Okay, so this is the proof of a Boolean equation using Boolean algebra. Now one more we will solve, that is also one proof. A B plus B naught C plus B naught C naught equal to A. Take this left hand side expression and simplify this. A B plus B naught C plus B naught C naught. So from these two, if I take B naught common, then C plus C naught for, according to the complementary law, 1. So here we are getting A into B plus B naught into 1. So A into B plus B naught. So now B plus B naught equal to again 1. So that 1 into A for C. It is out. So proved. Understood? So this is Boolean algebra using which we can simplify any Boolean expression or we can prove any Boolean equation. So that's all today up to this much. Hope next day we can start chapter 3 for Java. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.